Welcome to Attitude Baba. Today we are talking about an inspirational Indian who can inspire. She can inspire millions of people, and already she inspired. Let's understand who is her and what she is. Imagine, grenade blast survivor is now a beacon of hope for disabled people around the world. That is none other than Malvika Iyer, was a charming 13-year-old girl in 2002 when a grenade accidentally blew up in her hands, ripping her forearms and paralyzing her legs in Bikaner, Rajasthan, where she lived with her parents. An accident that could have ended her life completely changed her perspective, and even though it took years for her to overcome the trauma, she came out of the stronger and not only found a way to get her life back on track, but also became a harbinger of change for the disabled. It was a change in attitude of others which came along with the trauma that sensitized her towards the stigma associated with the disabled, and she chose not to take it lying down, but fight against it, and not only for herself but for many others like her. Now, at the age of 29, the Chennai-based activist has overcome her disability by sheer will and was honored with the prestigious Nari Shakti Puraskar Woman Power Award by President Ram Nath Kovind in March this year for pushing the envelope in making everyone understand the disability and come to terms of physical challenge. I grew up at Bikaner in Rajasthan, where my father was working as an engineer in the state water works department. The incident occurred on May 26, 2002, when I was 13-year-old studying in class 9. As I was rummaging the garage at home, I unknowingly held a grenade in hand that blew up, snapping my forearms and severely injured my legs, which lay dangling, recalled Malvika. A fire that broke out of the ordnance depot at Bikaner in January 2002 had flung pieces of ammunition in the vicinity, one of which claimed her arms. With just 4 months left for the 10th exams in 2004, she decided to appear as a private candidate in Chennai for Tamil Nadu Secondary School Leaving Certificates have missed in class 9 in 2002 and 3 after being hospitalized. Then the president, APJ Abdul Kalam sir, read about me in the newspaper and had invited me to Rashtrapati Bhavan. Sir had asked me about my career plans and spoke to me about missile making, Malvika fondly recalled. Facing a board exam with no arms and meeting a president like Kalam sir made me realize that I should never feel bad about anything lost. There was no looking back after this thought, asserted disability rights activist. I was very active throughout my childhood, good at sports, dancing, had a fun teen life. It wasn't easy to cope with losing my arms and seeing my legs weakened, but I soon felt that people's attitude to disabilities hurt more than disability itself. In 2013, she diversified her first public speech in Chennai, opening upon how the incident changed her life forever. Soon, she appealed to many nations across the world, demanding the better laws and facilities for the disabled. Every day, Malvika receives hundreds of messages from people across countries saying that I have been reason why they never give up in life. It is overwhelming that I am able to make a difference in people's lives, noted Malvika, who also turned a model to advocate accessible fashion. She is a member of Chennai Hub of Global Shapers Community, an initiative of the World Economic Forum to encourage young people below 30 to work for change, and the United Nations Interagency Network on the Youth Development, allowing her to carry her voice across the continents. I was humbled to receive a standing ovation from international delegates when I shared my story, the gender and disabled right advocated. It's Unfortunate that accessibility remains a major issue in our country. There is need for an attitudinal shift among the people, as the discrimination is the main obstacle for disabled making them feel excluded from society, she pointed out. I hope I can work the state-run bodies and education institutions to introduce a curriculum in schools for youngsters to understand disability and eliminate pity and stigma, Malvika said. This is the story of an Indian inspiring stories. Okay, so see the attitude, how she faced it, and she today become a leader in talking to people. Keep listening, guys. Thank you so much.